think he's going to go. They're not going to get him. The 20, 10, and he will bring it back. It's an interception return for a Rams touchdown. So from one end zone all the way to the other, talk about a turnaround.
And how about the excitement that that play generates for his team? Not just the points on the board, but the momentum and taking it from coast to coast, end zone to end zone. What a tremendous play. Now get that man an oxygen tent.
That's your boy Old Mo, you said momentum, right?
Old Mo, I think he's kind of limping across at the end because of that distance, but he made it.
Let's field it a few yards into the end zone. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. Philadelphia getting sent to take the field. And last time, decent field position through the pick six. Obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. All right, good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and press the advantage a little bit. They just have to be better with the football on this possession.
So the last, that didn't bother you too much last time?
No, because it's exactly what you're supposed to do. You can't have good field position, not try to take advantage of it. Sometimes the defense makes a good play, too.
And he is going to lose yardage here. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
When we did DeMarcus Ware's games in Dallas, didn't we spend most of the time talking about him rushing the passer?
We did, and how about now?
Oh, boy, he's expanded his game in a big way. Really does a great job in the run game now, using his length, using his leverage to hold the point of attack and make plays as we just saw there.
On second down, here's Breeze. And that one got tipped, kind of threw everything off. It brings up third.
Really nice play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball, but for the guys on the offensive line, they're doing a nice job of trying to protect their passer. But when a guy hops in the air and goes airborne to try and knock one away, it's difficult because you can't reach out and grab him. That'll be a holding penalty. So all you're trying to do is make some type of a play on him, make some type of contact to try and get his arms out of the sky.
And he finds his target. It's Sharp. And he gets it to the 32. Good enough for a first down. A good gain of 14 there, and it moves the chains. On first down, Breeze. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
Well, it doesn't take any great analysis. No jokes, partner, okay? All right, on this one. But we just know that we're going to see this as the game moves forward. There's going to be two guys on him on just about every snap.
It's kind of a dare to throw his way, but they have to keep throwing his way.
The benefits could be great. You throw it to a great receiver, he could come down with it anyway.
Breeze again here on second and 10. Throwing the out route incomplete. It's Johnson. They give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs. First down and 10 now for the offensive group. Again, they'll throw with Breeze. He's going to sling this deep downfield. Got a man, it's caught inside the 10. And he'll take it into the end zone for an Eagles touchdown. A big play there. 55 yards. And the Eagles are within an extra point of tying this thing up. It's good, and we're all tied at 7 apiece. So we're right back where we started. All even as the kick's away. This fielded at the 2. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. First time with Alvin Kamara. And a short gain there as he'll get it up only to about the 24. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
Gerald McCoy is always going to be linked with Ndamukong Suh. They came into the NFL in the same draft class. There's a lot of debate about who is going to be the better defensive tackle. They just do it two different ways. McCoy, more movement, more elusiveness. That allowed him to make the play there for a short gain.
It's a gain of six, moves him to a manageable third and two situation. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. Eluding the pressure right, and he'll slide down to avoid the contact. 5 yards on the scramble, and that's enough to pick up the first.
We just saw a nice example of why teams often bring in baseball guys to teach quarterbacks how to slide in key situations. You want to protect your franchise guy. Make sure he doesn't get hurt. He did exactly that on that play. A perfect slide to avoid the big hit and pick up a first down.
Over the middle, and it's incomplete. The 14-time Pro Bowler Tony Gonzalez, the intended receiver. That'll bring up second down. Ten yards still left on second down. He'll look to throw. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 47, and they will set up shop at their own 46-yard line.
And Brandon, this is a real nice job defensively of getting inside a quarterback's head and figuring out, okay, where is he going with the football? Because you can make an educated guess defensively, not all the time, but sometimes. And when you're right, you've got a decent chance of coming away with the football.
Now they'll run it on the toss. And he works his way forward for about four up to the midfield stripe.
In today's NFL, you hear all the time about stretching the field and creating space in order to run plays. A toss play will help accomplish that because now you're pushing a defense to chase you all the way to the edges and to the sideline. That's a nice run, probing now early to try and get things done later.
Back live with Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. It's the Eagles with the ball here to begin quarter number two. They've got it second and six to start things out. They'll send a receiver in motion left. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he's brought down. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks.
Tremendous blocking by the interior of the offensive line. They didn't just gash him there. They blasted a gaping hole for him to gallop through. And if he comes back to the huddle, he better be giving them a whole lot of credit and thanking them for that much space to rumble.
Johnson, the man in motion right. And to give this time to the tailback. And he'll be taken down at the 33, a pickup of about four.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
Breeze to throw on second down. Johnson with a completion over the middle. And they'll be inside the 25 now at the 24. 9 yards on the pickup there, and it keeps the drive alive. Yards. They take him down at the 26. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
Every year I go to the combine and marvel at the speeds that linebackers are running nowadays. They run like DBs, and let's face it, they know how to finish plays too. Eyes up, head up, run right through them.
Now Breeze throwing on second down. Escaping the pressure right. And now look at this. Big gain, but a fumble. And now the Rams have got it. Going the other way. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. And the Rams now coming out on the field. And tough starting field position here. Back to throw now in his own end zone. And he is out of bounds up around the 15. Trying to find some space to operate, and now they'll have it. A gain of 12, a big first down to get away from the end zone. To play in a tightly contested first half. We'll come back to Oakland after this. They'll run it now out of the gun. And not much there at all. He's up only to about the 16-yard line. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine.
The best defensive linemen, they play with great leverage so they can get low and not get bowled over by offensive linemen. They have excellent hands. They can throw people off on a play. We just saw a great example of a really good run stop by a guy playing the defensive tackle position.
Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down. On third down, he'll drop to throw. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
It's a lot of contact going on there, and in the end, unable to keep two hands on the football and bring it into his body.
Everything looked pretty good until the finish. So they're going to come to the line here, and it appears trying to go for it on fourth. They'll try and throw for it here. He's going to have his running back. It's complete. And he picks up the first before he's taken down at the 29.
We always talk about big-time players make big-time plays and big-time moments. I think that fourth down qualified. That was a heck of a throw.
And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. It's another 10 yards on that one and another first down. Now back to throw. They'll set up the screen now to Kamara. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 37-yard line. He lost two there, and it's third down. And that screen there on second down certainly didn't develop how they had hoped. Is that one they should have even tried, or is that one the quarterback sticks in his pocket?
I think the latter. I like what you said there, because trying it is one thing. We can second guess just about every call. But in this case, when you realize that it's broken down, just throw it at the feet of your intended receiver so that no one can pick it off, right? You don't have the ball tipped up in the air, and you come back and try and pick up the first down on third down. That way you don't lose any yardage.
And he's got room. Touchdown, LA! A great play there. 57 yards. And the Rams have taken the lead. And they're able to run it in. It started with a battle in the trenches. They won there, and they got in for 6 points.
And that's going to be a tough one for the defense to deal with. They've got to go to the bench now and figure out how we're going to slow down this running game, because on that particular play, they had no answer.
Zerline out now to kick this one away. That's fielded in the end zone. The decision to come out is going to cost him 5 as he's taken down right at the 20. Philadelphia getting set to take the field. And the ball backed way up, so thinking with this amount of time on the clock, probably just sit on it, and we'll see these two teams go to the lockers.
Yeah, I don't think you want to overthink it in this situation. Either side of the ball, just go ahead and finish up the half and get on out and talk about it.
They go play action here on first down. Flushed out right. Now he'll let it go deep right side. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Kyle Fuller. And now off to the races, down the right side. And he will bring it back. It's an interception return.